All right, so let's dive right in. We're taking a look at asteroid 2024 YR4 today.
Yeah.
And this one's been making headlines because it's on kind of an interesting path, we'll say.
Definitely interesting, yeah.
A little too interesting for comfort.
Yeah, too close for comfort, I would say.
So we've got a lot of research. We've got observations to sort through.
Right.
So to help make sense of it all, we have our expert here with us today.
Glad to be here.
I'm glad you're here. So really, what's got everyone's attention with this?
Well, I think what's really kind of got everyone riled up is that it went from just like a routine thing to like, oh, this is a priority.
Yeah, this isn't just some little speck out in space.
Right.
This is, what, three times the size of the Statue of Liberty?
That's what they're estimating, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, and early projections show it could impact Earth in 2032.
Yeah, that's the thing.
So everyone's kind of like, what? Hold on a sec.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess let's just start with the basics. When and where was this thing discovered?
Well, it was actually just a few weeks ago.
Okay.
December 27th, 2024.
Okay.
At the Sauce Observatory in Chile.
In Chile, okay.
Yeah.
And from there, how did we go from another asteroid to, oh, this could be a problem?
So the initial, I mean, the size estimate itself was like, okay, between 130 and 300 feet.
Okay.
I mean, that's, you know, that's a decent chunk of, you know.
Not insignificant.
Not insignificant.
Yeah.
But then when they started to calculate the trajectory.
Okay.
And NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, they ran the numbers.
Right.
And their findings suggest like a 1.6% chance of this thing hitting us.
Of it hitting Earth.
Yeah, on December 22nd, 2032.
2032, okay.
Yeah.
That's, I mean, 1.6%, that's small.
Yeah, it's small.
But it's not zero.
It's not zero, no.
So when we're talking about these kinds of probabilities with something like this,
right?
What does that, I mean, how do we interpret that?
I mean, it means we got to take it seriously.
Yeah.
Even though it's a small chance. An asteroid that size, you know, it needs attention right away.
Okay.
So, yeah, it's enough to trigger like a global response.
So, okay, so we know it's a certain size and it's got a certain chance of hitting us.
Mm-hmm.
But what are we talking about in terms of like impact? Like what would happen?
Yeah.
I mean, this isn't a dinosaur killer, right?
No. This is not a planet killer.
Okay.
But, you know, an asteroid this size could cause, you know, some damage.
Yeah.
It would be regional, you know, not global.
Right.
But pretty devastating, I'd say.
So more of a city killer.
Yeah, I think that's a good way to put it, yeah.
And a planet killer.
Yeah.
So can you, I mean, is there any way to give us an idea of like what kind of devastation we could be looking at?
I mean, to kind of understand, you know, the potential here,
you
got to think back to the Tunguska event in Siberia.
Okay.
That was in 1908.
Okay.
It was a similar size object.
Okay.
And it exploded in the atmosphere.
Okay.
But the shockwave, you know, flattened trees.
Right.
Like over 800 square miles.
Oh, wow.
Luckily, you know, it was a pretty sparsely populated area.
Right.
But it gives you an idea of, you know, what kind of energy we're dealing with.
Right. Yeah, that's a lot of energy.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, just to make things even more, I guess, complicated, this impact zone, that's not like one little spot, right?
Wow, no.
It's a pretty large area.
Yeah, I mean, based on where it's headed right now, it's, you know, from the Pacific Ocean to South Asia.
Wow.
Like that whole area is, you know.
It's a big chunk of Earth.
It's a big area, but, you know, it's important to remember.
Yeah.
This is all based on, you know, where we think it's going now.
Right.
And with more observation, more data.
That could change.
It could change, yeah.
So, okay, so we've got a lot of uncertainty. Mm-hmm. We got a lot of potential places that this thing could hit.
Right.
So the big question is, what's the plan? What are we doing about this?
Well, I think that's the good news here. Okay. That's what we're going to get into next. So the good news is scientists are already on it.
Okay.
Like around the world, everybody's working together.
That's good to hear.
Yeah. Gathering data, trying to refine.
So like all hands on deck in astronomy right now.
Pretty much. Yeah. Observatories everywhere, you know.
So what is all this data? What's going to tell us?
Right.
And how does it factor into like dealing with this thing?
So the data is crucial for a couple of reasons. Really, one, it's going to help refine like the path.
Okay.
You know, where it's actually going.
Right. Like, is it getting closer or further?
Exactly. Is the risk going up? Is it going down?
Right. Okay.
And then two, we got to figure out what it's made of.
Okay.
Like, is it solid rock? Is it a rubble pile?
Oh, okay.
That's going to tell us how to, you know, how to deal with it.
Right. Because you can't really approach a pile of rubble the same way you approach a solid rock.
Exactly. Yeah.
Okay. So more data equals better decisions.
Yeah.
But speaking of deflecting an asteroid, didn't we just do that?
Oh, you're talking about dart.
Yeah, dart. That's what it was called.
Yeah.
It's like we played cosmic billiards.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it.
And we slammed a spacecraft into an asteroid.
We did.
I mean, that just seemed so wild.
It was pretty amazing.
It actually worked.
It did. It was a huge step, you know, for planetary defense.
Yeah.
Like, we proved we can actually move these things.
That's huge.
It is. It's a game changer, really.
So how do we go from, you know, nudging this little asteroid to something like 2024 YR4?
Well, so it's not that simple, unfortunately. Yeah. DART's like, you know, proof that it can be done.
Yeah.
But this is a much bigger asteroid.
Right.
And there are some challenges.
Like what?
Well, time, for one. Yeah. Okay. DART took years to plan, you know, to build, to execute.
But with this one, we're on a tighter schedule.
I'm tighter, yeah.
So it's a race against time?
Yeah, you could say that.
What else? What other hurdles?
Well, money, of course.
Okay, yeah.
Missions like this are expensive.
Right.
And then there's, you know, global cooperation.
Oh, right.
This isn't something one country can just do.
It's got to be a team effort.
It has to be, yeah, everybody working together.
So time, money, global cooperation.
Mm-hmm.
Big factors.
Big factors, yeah.
But is DART the only option? Like, are there other ways to deflect this thing?
Yeah. There are a few other ideas out there.
Okay.
Some are kind of sci-fi, to be honest.
Oh, okay. Like what?
Well, there's laser ablation.
Laser ablation.
Yeah, it sounds kind of crazy.
Yeah, what is that?
So imagine, you know, a high-powered laser beam.
Okay.
Focused on the surface of the asteroid.
Okay.
The heat from the laser would actually vaporize some of the rock, create this jet of material, and that acts like a thruster.
So you're like slowly pushing the asteroid.
Exactly. A very, very gentle nudge.
That's incredible.
Yeah. Delicate process, but it could work.
So lasers. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else that's like out of a movie?
Yeah. There's the gravity tractor.
Gravity tractor. I like the sound of that.
Yeah. It's a pretty cool idea.
So what is that? Like a giant tractor beam?
No, it's actually very subtle.
Okay.
So you position a spacecraft near the asteroid.
Okay.
And you use its own gravity.
Oh, wow.
To pull the asteroid.
So a little spacecraft with its little gravity can pull a giant asteroid.
It's a very gradual thing, yeah.
How long would that take?
It would take a long time.
Like how long?
Years. Decades, maybe.
Wow. Okay, so we've got kinetic impactors, lasers, gravity tractors.
Yeah, those are the main ones, I'd say.
Is that it? Is that our toolbox?
For now, I think so.
So which one we use depends on a lot of things, I guess?
It does, yeah. The asteroid size, what it's made of.
Right.
How much time we have.
The money we have, I imagine.
Yeah, all those factors.
So it's a lot to take in.
It is, yeah.
But it is good to know that there are options.
Absolutely.
And that scientists are, you know, looking into all of them.
Yeah, they're not messing around.
But it's easy to get caught up in the what ifs, you know?
I know, it's scary stuff. Yeah, mm-hmm. All the worst case scenarios.
But it shows how far we've come, you know?
In what way?
Planetary defense. Like, we're actually taking this seriously now.
That's a good point, yeah.
We're not just sitting around hoping for the best.
So instead of reacting, we're kind of getting ahead of the game.
Yeah, we're developing tools, strategies to actually protect ourselves.
So 2024 YR4, it's a potential threat.
Right.
But it's also pushing us to be more innovative.
It is, yes, forcing us to work together.
On a global scale.
On a global scale, exactly.
But before we get too deep into all that,
okay.
We need to take a quick break.
Okay.
We'll be right back with more on 2024 YR4 and what this all means for the future of space exploration.
Sounds good.
Okay, so we're back and still diving deep on this asteroid 2024 YR4.
Yep.
We talked about its discovery,
right.
The threat, and you know what scientists are doing to track it and figure out like how to deal with it.
Mm-hmm.
But I kind of want to zoom out a bit here.
What does all this tell us about, you know, like how prepared we are for cosmic threats?
That's a good question.
Like in general.
I think 2024 YR4 is a good reminder. You know, we live in a dynamic solar system.
Right.
Things happen.
Yeah.
And sometimes those things, you know, come our way.
Right. Like we can't just ignore space.
No.
Because it's going to come knocking sometimes.
It will.
And we got to be ready.
We do.
It's like, yeah, we launch satellites, yeah. We send probes to Mars. Mm. But when something's coming towards us,
right.
It's like, oh, this is real.
It gets real, yeah.
It's not just some abstract concept anymore.
Exactly.
So it forces us to deal with it.
It does, yeah. And the good thing is,
okay.
We're not starting from scratch.
Okay.
You know, we have knowledge.
Yeah.
We have technology. We can work together.
We've learned some things.
We have, yeah.
So you're saying it's not all doom and gloom?
Not at all.
Okay, good.
I'm actually pretty optimistic. Yeah. I think this whole thing with 2024 YR4.
Yeah.
It's actually a good thing.
In what way?
It's bringing scientists together.
Okay.
It's pushing us to come up with new technologies.
Right.
And showing that we can cooperate, you know, globally.
So instead of just reacting, we're being proactive.
Exactly. We're preparing for, you know, whatever else might come our way.
Yeah, whatever the universe throws at us.
Exactly.
So it sounds like 2024 YR4.
Yeah.
It's a threat, but it's also an opportunity.
Probably so, yeah.
To really get serious about planetary defense.
Mm.
So as this is all unfolding,
right.
What are like the key takeaways we should keep in mind?
Well, first, I think, you know, keep observing.
Okay.
Keep collecting data.
Right. Because the more we know.
The more we know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The better.
The better we can deal with it.
What else?
Global cooperation.
Yeah.
We got to work together on this.
It's not a one country problem.
It's not. It's a planet problem.
So share information, pool resources.
Exactly. Work as a team.
Okay. And the third thing.
Communication.
Okay.
We got to talk about this.
Like with the public.
Yeah, educate people.
Right.
But not just about the risks.
Okay.
About what we're doing about it.
So no panicking.
No panicking, just, you know.
Being realistic.
Yeah, and working together.
Because we are all in this together.
We are, yeah. We're all crewmates on Spaceship Earth, you know.
Spaceship Earth, I like that.
Yeah.
It really puts things into perspective.
It does.
So there you have it, everyone.
Yeah.
A deep dive on 2024 YR4.
Mm-hmm.
It's still unfolding. And it's a story about challenges and opportunities and how we're all part of something much bigger.
Absolutely.
It shows what humanity can do when we work together.
It does.
So thanks for joining us on this deep dive.
My pleasure.
Until next time, keep looking up, stay curious, and remember, we're all crewmates.
On this big blue marble.
Exactly. And who knows, maybe someday we'll look back on this and say, hey, that's when we really got serious about protecting our planet.
I think so.
So until then, stay safe out there, space explorers.